Hello, everybody. This is another follow-up for the Volo economy tuner chip that I have installed in my 2002 Nissan Xterra. I usually use this this road right here, College Avenue. It's a great benchmark for testing miles per gallon. I don't know. It's very sunny out, so I don't know if it's getting washed out on my meter there. The reason why I like this spot for testing is because since it dips down below the normal surface of the road, of the ground, it's kind of dug out. There's no wind, very little wind to be either direction, actually, unless it's a particularly nasty day. So I don't have to worry too much about factoring in, wind blowing, going into a strong headwind, reducing my mileage or, having to make my truck work harder to be able to keep going. I'm off that road now. I got started a little late here in the video, but just a follow-up for this segment. We're still on College Avenue, just past College in Pennsylvania. Now we're entering Cudahy, Wisconsin, a suburb of Milwaukee. But now normally on that College Avenue road that I was just talking about, going past the airport there, I average about 20 miles per gallon, like I said, due to pretty much no wind resistance either direction. It's just plain old driving. Today, I averaged about 23, and it even, after a few, about 15 seconds on this flat straightaway, I actually went up to 25, and it stayed at about 25 until I got to the big hill and roundabout to come back out of it. So far, my observations with the Volo economy tuner and performance chip have been extremely pleasing. I have noticed that my truck is running, accelerates better from a stop. It was getting to the point where my truck just wasn't running like new anymore, which isn't surprising considering the royal beating this thing has taken over the past 11 years. But now my acceleration, I don't have to mash that pedal to get moving. It used to be like this thing was just accelerating like a dog. Couldn't get out of the way of its own butt. And sorry, I know you said butt, but I can't say the other word because then YouTube will flag my videos. And I'm not going through all that stupid hassle with YouTube again, especially since I'm doing so good with all my videos. I got a lot of subscribers going on here. So far, I am going to have to give this chip a rating. So I am seeing a definite improvement. Was not expecting a performance increase, but I did. The big performance noticeable increase is off the line. Acceleration is quite a bit better. Not blisteringly fast. This is a six-cylinder truck that's geared for pulling, towing torque. Not for acceleration. This is definitely not a sports car vehicle. It still does not feel like a sports car, but it is fairly pleasing. Let's see what we get locked in. I lock at 30 miles per gallon. We're going up a pretty nice incline. And going up this incline, it's also a nice benchmark I do. I drive the same spot every day. Traffic's always nil. We're getting 18.9, went down to 15.9, 13, 12.7. The hill's getting quite a bit steeper here. Mind you, we're in third gear at 30 miles an hour. And we're hovering about 14.6, 13.8 to about 15.6, roughly, is what we're at. We're leveling off. I'm going to change lanes and hope that I can get past this light. Come on, light change. Nope, gotta slow down. Uphill there, I'm usually at about 10 and a half, 11, sometimes 12, low 13. So just the fact that I hit 15 is a good sign. Okay, we're on almost perfectly flat road now with slight variations, but this is as flat as you're gonna get anywhere in Milwaukee County. And I'm at 23. Down to 16, 16.5, 19.1. Now we're evening off a little more. It is still a slight, very, very slight incline, And we're actually sustained 19.4 for about 6 seconds. Now we're up to 23, 22, 20. And I'm slowing down here. Red light. And because this red light takes forever, I'm going to take the back streets. So that's it for actually measuring mileage, since I won't be able to do a good sustained speed back here. And, back to what I was saying about improved power. Which, since I did not purchase the power chip, I purchased the economy chip. I don't care how much power I have, for the most part. If it takes me a little longer to get from A to B pulling a 5,000-pound trailer, that's great. But if I can... if it takes me a little longer to get from A to B pulling a 5,000-pound trailer, that sucks. But if I can do that in a little bit more time and save 15 bucks in gas, that's great. So, also power-wise, with my 5,000-pound loaded trailer, I could not use cruise control at all, because I do a run from Green Bay to Wisconsin Dells, which is about a two-hour drive, 120-ish miles, a lot of uphill, downhill. I could never use cruise control, empty or full trailer, because my transmission would just start seeking. It'd get a little too high of a power, a load, and then downshift, trying to keep my speed up. However, my last trip there, I was able to do a good 60% of the trip without having, or with using cruise control, which is unheard of. And I tell you, it does save a lot of pain in your foot. That Charlie horse just did not creep up on me this time. So I have arrived at my shop. I know some of you just do not know me that well, so... hop out here, just do a little quick, and I'm trying to keep this as focused as possible, but a little difficult while you're driving. At idle, I think I went over idle once before. I don't know if we can get it here. Right now we're idling at 0.41 gallons per hour. Before, I was normally averaging about 0.45 gallons per hour. Now we're at 184 degrees water temperature. I wonder if I turn this. Hey, I'm trying to turn. There we go. I wonder if I turn the light on. There we go. 0.41. We're at about 184 degrees water temperature. Without the chip, when I hit about 190 to 192 degrees water temperature, without the chip, I was still at about 0.43 gallons per hour. Now, with the chip, I actually have gone as low as 0.37 gallons per hour once I hit about 190, 192 degrees. Kill motor. Here's our lovely neighbors. United Welding and Manufacturing, they built some pretty awesome stuff there. Right there is Lattice Manufacturing. They've built parts of the space shuttle, or not space shuttle, space capsules. The old capsules, I think the Apollo ones. There's my shop right there. Customs Unlimited, 3650 East Adams. We sell some of the most awesome scooters and motorcycles known to man. Custom-built cycles, and we also build electric cars, custom, whatever custom you might want. So that's it for this video. I will do probably a couple more updates of the Volo. In case some of you didn't see it, that's where I got it mounted. There are four lights. Two are solid usually while the truck's running, and the other one's activity and link seem to blink randomly, probably whenever it's communicating with the ECU. So there we have it. Have a good one.